morning student, welcome here in this YouTube channel. Well, as you all know that we are discussing about unit number 5, that is revolutionaries of India. Sukhdev, Bhagat Singh, Bismil, Madam Kama, Shyamji Krishna Varma, these all are the names of revolutionaries who have fought for our country and who just helped us to get freedom. So these are the revolutionaries, and most of the revolutionaries we have discussed. Today in this video we will discuss two revolutionaries. First among them is Shyamji Krishna Varma. After that we'll go for Madam Kama. Okay, so you are requested to keep a textbook with you. See, Shyamji Krishna Varma, picture number 5.9 is about Shyamji Krishna Varma. Shyamji Krishna Varma was born on 1857 in Mandvi village of Kutch. So it is our proud that Shyamji Krishna Varma is a Gujarati. So he was born in Kutch in Mandvi district on 4th October 1857. He was the pioneer of revolutionary activities abroad. He graduated from the Oxford University. So you can imagine how powerful that personality was, as he just graduated from Oxford University. He played a vital role in establishing the Indian Home Rule Society. So you know this about that, what this Indian Home Rule Society. So in that, this Shyamji Krishna Varma played very important role in London on 18th February 1905. So that society was established in 1905, and it was established in London. Its office was his house, and it was given the name India House. For the propagation of his institution, he started a magazine entitled Indian Sociologist. So he wanted to spread the culture, and he wanted to spread the information about Indian society to whole world, and for that he just started a magazine entitled Indian Sociologist. Shyamji Krishna Varma was associated with Vinayak Savarkar, Lala Hardayal, Madanlal Dhingra, Sardar Singh Rana and Madam Kama in the revolutionary activities. So these are the people who were there with Shyamji Krishna Varma in revolutionary activities. He arranged scholarship for Indians. So he was there in London. He was working for India. Means he had a passion to do something for India. And for that, what did he do? He just allowed scholarship for Indian. In 1909, C. Madanlal Dhingra shot dead Sir William Wiley near Trafalgar Square in London, for which he was hung to death. So these are the activities he had done for India, and for that he had to hung. Feeling unsafe in London, Shyamji Krishna Varma shifted to Paris. After some time he shifted to Switzerland. He died in 1930. See, Madanlal Dhingra was shot by Madanlal Dhingra shot dead Sir William Wiley near Trafalgar Square in London, for which he was hung to death. Means who was hung to death? So Madanlal Dhingra was hung to death because he just shot Sir William Wiley in London. And after that, what happened? Shyamji Krishna Varma didn't find himself safe in London, so he shifted to Paris, and after that he shifted to Switzerland. He died in 1930. So this is Shyamji Krishna Varma and his contribution as a revolutionary for India. Let me write the keywords for this. So we can say on 4th October he was born. In 1857, born in Kutch, Mandvi, graduated from London graduated from Oxford University. इंडियन होम रूल सोसाइटी. मैनी अदर रेवोल्यूशनरीज मदनलाल ढींगरा वॉज हंग. And after that, Shyamji Krishna Varma shifted himself to Paris as he didn't find himself safe in London. After that, he went to Switzerland, and there in 1930, he was dead. So this is Shyamji Krishna Varma and the keywords of this. Please you note down this. After that, we'll go for Madan Kama. Now next is Madan Kama. The last revolutionary of this unit is Madam Bhikhaji Rastomji Kama. Madam Kama was born on 24th September 1861 in Mumbai. She stayed in London from 1902 to 1907 CE. In 1905 CE, she was an associated of Shyamji Krishna Varma in establishing Indian Home Rule Society. So Madam Kama was also there with Shyamji Krishna Varma to establish this Indian Home Rule Society. Basically, she was born in Mumbai, but she was there in London. She stayed in London in 1902 to 1907. She was present in Second International Socialist Conference held in Stuttgart of Germany in 1907. In this conference, she unfurled the tricolor flag with the slogan Vande Mataram. She was there in International Socialist Conference held in Stuttgart of Germany in 1907. And she just there unfurled this our tricolor flag with slogan Vande Mataram. So we can say that she was a very brave lady. See, this keyword for this is born on 1861 in Mumbai. Stayed in London from 1902 to 1907. She was associated with Indian Home Rule Society. Vande Mataram slogan. So this is Madam Kama and the keywords of this. Please you note down this, and here we have ended this unit. Now we'll go for unit number 6. Please you note down this. So this is unit number 5, and now we are going to start unit number 6. Unit number 6 is human resources. Okay, so this unit is about human resources. Let's see this. Do you know the way we collected information about the whole class? Similarly, we can collect information about the entire population, and it's done at a regular interval. Let's discuss that. Now, about in this unit, we will discuss about this human resources, and that is first is what is census? Why is it carried out? Census word, you have heard this word. You know what is this census? Collection and cataloguing of information about people living in the country or any particular region of the country is known as census. First of all, this census has connection with population word. Means the population of the country, population of any region, particular region. In simple word, we can say that is known as census. Collection and cataloguing of information. Another thing, collection of information about people living in a country. This is the simple definition of census. It is done every 10 years under the regulation of central government, and we know this, it is done in every 10 years under regulation of central government. Okay, the last census in our country was carried out in the year 2011. So now in 2021 this census will take place. So we can say here, lastly in 2011. It was done for the 7th time after the independence. So after independence, it was 7th this census. In the census of 2011, there was a provision of providing unique ID number एंड आइडेंटिटी कार्ड टू एवरी सिटीजन. इट वॉज द स्पेशल फीचर्स ऑफ सेंसस 2011. इट इज अवर ड्यूटी टू प्रोवाइड करेक्ट इन्फॉर्मेशन टू द गवर्नमेंट. सो इट इज अवर प्राइम ड्यूटी टू प्रोवाइड करेक्ट इन्फॉर्मेशन टू द गवर्नमेंट. एंड when it was held in 2011, at that time unique ID number and identity card was given to each and every citizen of India. Please you note down this. After that I'll give you some more keywords. Please note down. So we can say, student, this census means collection of the population of any country. Means how many people are living, what is the population of that country, that is maintained or that is collected by this census. This census is held in every 10 years under the regulation of central government. Lastly, it was held in 2011 and in 2011 when it was held, it was the 7th census after independence. So this is the information about that. Now more information. Unique ID number and identity card. Human resource is the human capital of our country. The development of a nation depends on its human capital. It is the wealth of the nation. Development of a country depends not only on the area of the country or its natural resources, but it is also based upon the quality and quantity of human resources that contribute a lot to the economic development. So, this human resources are the key is necessary to the development of any country. Means only natural resources are not required to the development of country. If country wants to develop, wants to be developed economically, so these human resources are very important. The health, education, professional skills and ambitions increase the productivity of the nation, and as a result the country develops. So these are known as human resources. Means country people's health, country people's education, country people's professional skills and country people's ambitions are playing major role in this development. This is done in order to take necessary measures. Census is mandatory in order to plan out country's 5-year development plan in record to food, water, housing facility, industry, electricity, employment, education, conservation. Nowadays, Forest Department keeps a record of endangered animals, birds and plants. Even domestic animals are counted. So not only people or human beings are counted, but nowadays change is there, and forest departments are having that list or numbers of endangered animals, birds and plants. Even domestic animals are being counted nowadays. So this much our government is being alert. So important and mandatory. Now, an estimate of the population of India. Okay, second topic is means how much population of India is, that is the estimate in this topic. The total land area of our country is 30,27,263 square kilometer, which is 2.42% of the world's total land area. So we have 2.42% of the world's total land area. So from 100%, India has 2.42% of the world total land area. Area wise, India stands 7th in the world. Okay, more than 16% of the world's population lives in India. So India stands second in term of population after China. You please note down this, after that we'll go further. More than 16% of the world's population lives in India. 16%. So we can say India stands second in population after China. Qualitative human population is also called human resources. The quantity of human resources depends on education and intelligence. Skilled citizens like doctors, educationalists, engineers, sportsmen, industrialists, businessmen, farmers, artisans, laborers, and the other responsible citizens are the human resources. Children and youth are potential resources. So you might know that what are human resources. So these skilled citizens like doctors, education, sportsmen, industrialists, businessmen, farmers, artisans, these all are called human resources. And children and youth. These are the potential resources. क्वालिटी ऑफ ह्यूमन रिसोर्सेस डिपेंड्स ऑन एजुकेशन एंड इंटेलिजेंस. ओके, सो दिस इज द एस्टिमेट ऑफ पॉपुलेशन ऑफ इंडिया स्टूडेंट्स. प्लीज यू नोट डाउन दिस, आफ्टर दैट वील गो फर्दर. So this is for today's video, student. Now it's time to give you homework. Your homework is write a note on Madam Kama and what is census give detailed information. About it, we'll go in detail about this population and about census in next video. Till then, take care. Bye. Thank you.